Hello dear students, how are you all? Hope you and your family is safe and healthy. So we are welcome back with the new chapter series of semester 3rd. The subject is pharmacognosy and phytochemistry 1. As the subject says, different phytochemistry of the plants, different plants. So here the new chapter is lipids. So you all are thinking, what are lipids? What we have to study under lipids? So the content of the lipid is, what are the lipids, different fats, oil, waxes, and in this content we have to study about waxes, fat and fixed oil. These waxes, fat and fixed oil comes under the lipids, and these are the four drugs that you have to study under lipids. But there are so many drugs which contain lipids. So the drugs are castor oil, Chalmogra oil, wool fat and beeswax. These are the four drugs that you have to study under lipids. So let us study first, what is lipids, the definition of lipids, chemical properties of the lipids, classification of the lipids. You also have to study about the analysis of the lipid. If the any drug containing the lipids, then how can you evaluate that this drug contain the lipids? You have to do analysis by the different test, and this test is used in the research laboratory or the laboratory scale to find out the lipid content. Okay, and that these are the drugs, four drugs we have to study in this chapter. First of all, the definition of lipid. What are lipids? Lipids are the insoluble inorganic compound. First remember that they are insoluble organic compounds that consist of fat and oil. As I am saying, lipids contain fat, oil and waxes, so that contain the fat and oil. And the chemical composition of this consists of three: hydrogen, carbon and the oxygen. And they provide high energy and perform different biological function of the body. In our physiological body process, lipids play an important role. Important role in what? Important role in provide the structure to the cell membrane, in storage and performing the storage of the energy. They also act as a function signaling pathway, and the lipids are of different types. Lipids, chemically we can say that they are soluble in organic solvents and insoluble in water. They are the storage of energy. They can be extracted by different methods, and they can be evaluated by the different tests. As I have said, tell you that for the analysis of lipids, we have to use different tests. Now, this is the complete structure you can see here. For the fat, oil and waxes are the naturally occurring esters. You can see in the structure that they are the naturally occurring ester and are long stretch carboxylic acids. They are the long stretch chain carboxylic acid. So when fatty acid and glycerol combines, they can give triglyceride. You can see here in the structure triglycerides. So when fatty acids combine with the glycerol, and we combine this both the formula structurally, they can form the triglycerides. Now, fatty acids on hydrolysis yields the which fatty acid? They are long chain carboxylic acid, you know. So naturally fatty acids are two: saturated and unsaturated. Saturated have higher melting point, and fatty acid, two polyunsaturated fatty acids, that is linoleic and linolenic, are essential because their absence in human diet lead to the health problem. So these are the two fatty acids which are very necessary for the human body. Now, this acid, the important point for the acid, that these fatty acids are the precursor for the prostaglandin. And you, as you all know, that prostaglandin is an important part of our body. So these acids are precursor. Precursor means starting material. They help in synthesis of the prostaglandins. Now, this is the difference between the fat and oils. Fat means they are high proportion of saturated fatty acid. And oil has high proportion of unsaturated fatty acid. Fats melt at higher temperature. Oil melt at low temperature. As they melt at low temperature, they are usually liquid at the room temperature. So these are sometimes question may ask between the difference between fat and oil. There you can say like this: they are the saturated, they are the unsaturated. Now comes the waxes, fat, oil and waxes. I have cleared you about fat and oil. Now comes to the waxes. Waxes are the ester of fatty acid with long chain monohydric alcohol. Here comes the monohydric alcohol. Fatty acid and alcohols have 24 to 36 carbon atom, and they are fully reduced hydrocarbon chain, and they are chemically inert and not digested by any fat splitting agent. These waxes are not digested by any enzymes. Now, this is the structure for the waxes. You can see here, this is the sample, and you can see in the figure of the beeswax. Now, difference between fat and waxes. Fat may be saponified by aqueous or alcoholic alkali, but waxes only saponified by alcoholic alkali. So these are the differences between the fat and waxes. Now comes the fixed oil. Fixed oil are the esters of fatty acid with glycerol. Here you can see the structure of the glycerol. How many carbon atoms are there in glycerol? 3. And H and OH group are there. So these fixed oil are the esters of fatty acids and glycerol. Now fixed oil, as you all know, are the ester of fatty acid and glycerol. They may be of different type: monoglyceride, triglyceride and diglyceride. Mono, di and tri. As the name suggests, mono means single, di means double and tri means 3. As you all see the differences in the structure of mono, di and triglycerides. Now the most important point, the physical property. Whenever you can evaluate, whenever you want to evaluate anything, first you can see it physically and evaluate. So physically it is thick. As you all know, fat and oil may always be thick, viscous, they are yellow colored, they are non-volatile, they cannot be distilled, they do not have any food value, and the most important point is that they turn rancid on storage. Rancid means they degrade. When we keep fat or oils for a long time, they become rancid. Odor change, taste change, okay, and they are used as in pharmaceutical importance. They are used as emollient and demulsants. Now the chemical properties are of fixed oil or fatty acids are the hydrolysis, oxidation. What is hydrolysis? When fat are hydrolyzed with alkali, they yield fatty acid and glycerol. The procedure when they yield fatty acid and glycerol is known as hydrolysis. Lysis means breakdown. Oxidation means oxidation of fats in the air take place with the hydrolysis. Another is hydrogenation, and next is the hydrogenolysis. Hydrogenation, unsaturated plant fats when converted into saturated, they are called as hydrogenation, and breaking down of that is known as hydrogenolysis. So I have given all the description of the chemical properties of the fixed oil or fatty oils. Now comes the chemical test. So the two main chemical tests for the fixed oil are sodium hydroxide test and sodium hydrogen sulfate test. You can identify the fixed oil by using any one of the name test. Next is the chemical test for lipids. For chemical test of the lipid, we can use the name test like Sudan 4 test, grease spot test. We can also use the emulsification test. So these are the tests you can use for the chemical classification of the lipids. Now, classification of the lipids is mainly three types of lipids: simple, compound and derived. And what we are studying is the simple lipid, oil, fat and waxes. Now the compound lipids means phospholipid, glycolipid and glycoprotein, and derived lipid comes under fatty acid and cholesterol. Again, fatty acid are of two types: saturated and unsaturated. Now saturated is single one, unsaturated means polyunsaturated and monounsaturated. Polyeconocytes bhi bolte hain, polyunsaturated again divided into prostaglandin, prostacyclin, thromboxin and leukotrienes. So this is the entire classification of the lipids. Lipids, if you go through the simplification of that classification, in if you are thinking what are phospholipid, so phospholipid contain means lecithin, plasmologen, these are all the very important physiological importance in the human body, sulfolipids. So these are the more simplified form of the classification of lipids. Now the important portion for the exam point of view, from the normally learning point of view, how to analyze anything or any question in the drug testing, come to the analysis. So how you analyze is fat and oil by the different methods like acid value, saponification value, ester value, acetyl value, hydroxyl value and iodine value. And physically, they can be determined by melting point, refractive index, viscosity, these are. So one by one, we could say that gas chromatographic determination of fatty acid is also can be done. So different analytical parameter include, first one is the acid value. Acid value means it indicate the amount of free fatty acid present in oil or fat. For this, procedure is there for the titration. We can do the titration and can find out the acid value. But acid value is the amount of free fatty acid present in oil and fat. Number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide. When we will do the titration, we can see that how many number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide required to neutralize the free organic acid in which in 1 gram of fat. This is called as the acid value. Next is the saponification value. Number of milligram of potassium hydroxide required to saponify 1 gram of fat. And this is the procedure for the titration of the saponification value. Then comes the iodine value. What is iodine value? Number of gram of iodine taken up by the 100 gram of fat in oil. Means the degree of unsaturation will give you the idea of the drying character of the oil or the fat. This is the calculation for the iodine value. We can use the formula A minus V 1.27 divided by W, where weight of oil is W. A is the blank, reading of blank. B is the reading of actual. And we can calculate the iodine value by using this formula. Different types of analytical methods are also there. Richard Missy value, acetyl value means number of mg of potassium hydroxide required to neutralize the acetic acid. Liberated means liberated by the saponification of 1 gram of oil or fat. So except castor oil, most of the oil or fat have low acetyl value. So I can conclude here that castor oil has the acetyl value highest, that is 150. Now, Polskin value means number ml of 0.1 of potassium hydroxide needed means required to neutralize the steam volatile is known as the Polsky value. So, these are the six important analytical parameters. Now, one by one, we have to study the drugs like castor oil. I have explained you in detail about in our lecture, online lecture also about all the drugs. But here, I am making you just overview or the summary of this drug like castor oil. We have to study what in these drugs. We have to study the biological source, composition of the seeds, what are the chemical composition of the seeds, how oil is obtained, what are the how seeds can be seen. Now preparation of how the oil can be extracted from the castor seeds. Morphology means physical description, color, odor, taste. Chemical constituent means how much of fixed oil it contain, protein, different constituent are there, different acid, linoleic, stearic acid, what are the major constituent of this. Different tests can be used for the identification and what are the uses. So the main use of the castor oil is the cosmetic purpose. Castor oil is widely used. It is also used in the pharmaceutical purpose. It is also used as a raw material for the synthesis of various resins. Second drug is the chalmogra oil. Chalmogra oil is also called as hydnocarpus and gynocardia oil. So this is the name of the chalmogra oil. The question also came like the hydnocarpus oil. So same, you have to understood that it is the chalmogra oil. So biological source, again morphology, method of preparation, chemical constituent you have to study in this oil. Then after chemical constituent, structure. Structure is the most important thing. If there you have to draw. Not all the three structure are compulsory, but you have to draw the main structure of the major constituent. Uses. In the leprosy and skin diseases, it is widely used. Chalmogra oil also has a bacteriostatic properties. Also used for the external purposes. Next is the beeswax. Beeswax are of two types. White beeswax and yellow beeswax. So again, we have to study the morphology, preparation of the beeswax from the honeycomb. How to prepare bleaching. By bleaching, we can change the color of the beeswax. So there is a procedure of the beeswax. This is the standard points according to the IP specific value for evaluation of the beeswax melting point specific chemical constituent. Beeswax mainly contain myrcene, myrcel palmitate. So the chemical constituent is very important. Chemical test, no turbidity is produced in the beeswax. Saponification clot test is importantly used for the chemical test of beeswax. Uses: it is always used in the preparation of ointment, in the cosmetic industries, also in dental industry for the plaster, for the dentures, preparation of the dentures. Next is the wool fat. Wool fat is also called as lanolin. So biological source, how, from where it is obtained, again the morphology, how wool fat is prepared, chemical constituent of the wool fat. Then we have to study the wool fat contain the major liquid lanolin is rich in low molecular weight, aliphatic acids and alcohols. Chief constituent are cholesterol, isocholesterol. These are the main constituent of the lanolin. Then this is the structure for the cholesterol, main constituent structure. Identification test, how to test the wool fat or lanolin. And lanolin is used as an adsorbent, as an emollient. So we have to know the uses of the wool fat also. So these are the four drugs under which you have to study in the same parameter. Now the important question that can be asked from this chapter are given and listed below. You can refer these important questions. Same questions what I have explained you have been asked in the exam repeatedly again and again. And the better references for these are also given. And thank you. Be safe. Stay healthy and please subscribe to our PharmaIgnite channel. Thank you.